Hello there, my dear. Did you get lost in the forest? Oh, I see. Well, we'll just have to fix that, won't we? Don't worry, I can fix you right up. Let's start with a healing charm, shall we? Are you already feeling better? Good. Now I can see that there are all these negative energies floating around. And they seem to be floating around your head. I'm assuming someone must have put a curse on you. Or spell. At any rate, we'll have to get rid of them, won't we? Don't be worried. I've done this a million times already. I'll just pluck the negative energies from you and you'll feel better in no time. You might hear some strange sounds and noises, but don't worry. That's all part of my spell. So let's begin. Already feeling better, my dear? Good. Now, to completely get rid of the charm, we'll simply have to cast a counter curse, won't we? Don't worry. I have a selection of ancient spellbooks here. And those can help us get rid of all that negative energy completely. You'll notice that these books are spelled to you, a regular human. They simply look like regular books. One is a biography of Catarina de' Medici, and the other two are volumes about cultural history. But to me, a witch, these books are anything but ordinary. I've spelled them so that humans can't see what's actually underneath. It wouldn't be good if humans got hope of some of these spells and potions. So let's see. Which one do we need? is determined to interrupt our spellcasting. So here we go. Our countercast, which means if it worked properly, which I'm sure it did, I'm a very proficient spellcaster. This means that the curse has been revoked and you should be feeling better any second now. Let's just put this away, shall we? So tell me, what are you doing here in the forest? There's no place for regular humans as you. Oh, I see. You were here because of your work. Well, if you don't mind me asking, what exactly do you do? Librarian? But that doesn't really answer my question, does it? I mean, there are no books in the forest, as far as I know. I mean, except for my spell books, which I can assure you, I cannot give you, unfortunately. Oh. You're here to write a new book. And what exactly are you searching? Of adventure. Oh, folk tales, fairy tales. Well, you are right. The Dark Forest does have a lot of legends and stories, histories connected to it. That is certainly true. But it is also true that it is very dangerous for humans to venture into the forest. I would not recommend it. Oh, you've heard stories about me. Not very kind ones, I'm sure. Oh yes, I've heard that one. Don't worry. I'm not in the habit of eating children, as they say. In fact, I'm not very fond of children as it is. They're quite loud creatures. And they do tend to make a mess of things. I'm not fond of messes. I would rather have things be organized around the house. So you see, children would not be a good meal for me. What do you do with all those stories and legends you've collected? Oh, I see. Well, I can see you're quite exhausted. If you want to, take a nap here in my cottage. And in the morning, when the weather is better, and when you're feeling better as well, you can go home. I could even help you find your way back. I can tell that you must have gotten lost in the forest, and it is quite a tricky place to be. Without a map or any directions, you would be quite lost.